that floor. So I won't do it anymore. I used to get a free turn there, but I added OEs to the team, and now it's not safe anymore. I've been wondering what changed. I forgot about the OEs, but there's been other times where I cut that floor really close. Okay, we'll no longer try to stall a turn there. Bot and Blob. We're going to have to stall a turn some other way. Yeah, I haven't 100%, like, that's another reason I don't always like OEs, because of the volatile damage. DMing custom content is tough. Like, DMing modules is already really hard. So I was trying to make my own custom campaign before I went back to school and had to give it up. And I was spending like 12 hours or more, at least 12 hours for every 4-hour session we played. So it was taking 16 hours of every 2 weeks at best. I mean, because if you're writing like all your own custom stuff, you've got to think about storylines and characters to interact with. And plus, the campaign I was trying to run was 9 players. So I was trying to give all of them agency in the storyline. And I was also doing a lot of campfire RPing, which is where you let them RP directly with the DM or directly with another person in between sessions. It's not that bad. The only issue with 9-player D&D is that you basically separate it into 2 types of games. So which you basically have to do the combat RP. You can't have little bit of combat, little bit of RP, because it takes so long to get into the combat, get established, get everyone comfortable with how the turn order is working and do everything to make it fun and not drag on forever. Because, you know, if you have like 9 plus players, it just takes forever to even get the initiative order set up, right? So by the time you've gotten the initiative order set up, you don't want to waste it. And also, you have to put a lot of effort into making combat challenging but not trivial or super deadly for that many players, because if you do it wrong, then you end up with encounters that are just really, really easy. Or someone makes a mistake and steps in between like 10 soldiers and they go, oh, we don't have anyone else to target. That guy's dead. I think it's if you have to ask, then you don't know. Or you can't know. But I did just hit level 5, Panda, on my paladin. Level 5, man. Dude, a level 5 paladin is a single target DPS god. Like... I went and checked like my damage output, and I can probably do like almost 120 damage to something that's undead at level 5 in a single round of combat. Yep, level 5. So, what you... Basically, I have a low-grade Sunblade. It doesn't have, like, everything that a Sunblade has, but it does do an extra D8 radiant damage to undead. So, I could do... 1D8 plus strength, right? Or plus the damage. So 1d8 for the base weapon, then 2d8 for a smite, then another 2d8 for a thunderous smite, prepped on the weapon. And then the smite does an extra d8 of radiant damage. The sword does an extra d8 of radiant damage. And then I also have two attacks now, so I could do another smite. And the sword and the smite get another 1d8 of radiant damage. Anyone know off the top of their head the best stamina for experienced dungeons? It's Alt Shura 1 by far. If difficulty doesn't matter to you, ASR1 is more experience, is it? Or ASR2? I thought ASR1 was still more experience. Are you sure? ASR 2 is Alt Ruler of Hell's Halls, yes. Doopy doo. My first ASR 2 was 47 million. My first ASR 1 is 40. Oh, okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So we don't have that nice magical number. Mitokage is super annoying and it cuts it really close, I think. We do have OEs now. Nah, I'm not gonna worry about it. We're probably fine. I used to worry about this floor. Now with the OEs, I think it's fine. We'll learn. All right. Easy floor. Okay, well, we got 10C. We should be fine. Love that board. Okay, DQXQ is probably our hardest spawn. This is really tough. Just take our Corb. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, Oh, Skyfall, please don't screw me. Well, that's what we get for missing the first one and then hitting the second one. By the way, 10C is safe. You got a working 3P carry build for Nepdragon. That's exciting. Like, DQXQ is just hard no matter what. That's a hard spawn. I think from now on, I'm just gonna chip. I'm not even gonna VDP because it's just so likely you're gonna get screwed by Skyfall. Didn't get the other corbs. All right, two's fine. I really like this 10C comp. Me too. I've got it to where it covers all spawns. It does require some skill because it is a little bit short on move time, but I think it's really good. How much move time? 9.5 seconds. Or 9 seconds. I tried to fit Kaiba equip, because Kaiba equip gives an extra second and a half. 9 seconds. Well, it's either about the same, or my MD2T might be 8.5. MD2 is like easier though. There's way more troll spinners in Colo 4. This dungeon's way harder than MD2 in my opinion. It's just it's more accessible because the HP requirements aren't as bad. They're still pretty bad, but they're not as bad. Like, a board with that many moves to solve is a little sketchy on 9 seconds. You have to, like, always move. Is it possible to kill blue melee with BB before the dark unmatchable? Yes. Is it possible to kill it before dark? I don't think you could three-shot her. I don't think it's... You'd have to, like, cap out on all your sub-attributes every time, right? I mean, that's the only dark sub-attributes you have, right? That's what I'm talking about. Because that would be 8.5 plus 8.5, so 17. Plus 8.5. 25-ish. That's really close. Yeah. Because it takes almost 34 billion damage every turn to get the kill. Skyfall saved us. I got lost in the sauce on the blinds. That's why we stall a turn, by the way. Because it lets us, like, be completely rid of the blinds. Because you can make mistakes. And I got caught up trying to remember which one was green and which one was dark. When I shouldn't even bothered. Should have just started matching. And went for it. But Skyfall saved us. So, you know, whatever. So we got one of each color here too. It's so annoying. That one's light. Okay. This one's dark. Heart snuck in there. Okay. Now this starts getting weird. Okay. We had too many hearts on board. So... Hold up. By the way, quick question. How hard did I roll Kamen Rider? A little both times, but I got a lot of stuff. But there's a couple like critical ones I did miss out on. Why do you ask? That's the dark one, right? I do not have the dark one. Yes. No, I don't have him. I mean, he's not very good. He was definitely not worth the trade fodder, and he's still not worth the trade fodder. Is it DQXQ time again? It is. Okay. If we don't get it first try, we have to chip. Ooh, this is a good board. Alright, good hit.
Hey, get out of my hardware. What are you doing?
Wet the system.
What?
Like water hitting the ground, sinking in.
Oh, God, you're everywhere.
Dang, dude, yeah, it's almost a year. Thank you for the sub, dude. Happy Sunday to you. I know you've been really busy with school and stuff, so I appreciate you still coming by. Nah, I'm gonna make it this time. This board looks pretty good. Okay, let's hit the Sephira button and check it out. Not too bad. Because I'm going to touch the Shura button. And that's going to give... The rest of the non-light orbs will be light. Except for that one. Alright, where's our easiest place to form the VDP at? Bottom right looks good at first glance. But that may not actually be the easiest place to do it. Maybe it is. Maybe it is. I feel like I should kill here because it's risky. Yeah, we're gonna just kill. It's too risky. It'd be best if we had like another turn, but it's just too risky. Wish I had more confidence. That was a good DQ XQ board. I didn't want to wait till the last turn. Inahime. Definitely gonna take advantage and chip here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. One short of core VDP. But we don't need to core VDP. Corbs are fun. Hey, marginally. All right, we got DQ. It's not really possible to one-shot her. Dao-chan, I mean, not DQ. Dao-chan. Tried to save the Corbin, ended up burning it anyway. Stop skill downing me. It's fine. Fine. You just need her to not skill down one turn. Hopefully she'll skill up. That was not a skill up. Okay, it's only one turn. We only got one turn. Okay, we're fine. We're golden here. Man, you're annoying, Dao-chan. So annoying. Man. All the grandises of this build are all so sketchy. Oh, green dis is free. But red and blue are both scary. Always better to go into this. Granted, either zero or one normal grandis is that thing. Yeah, no, zero then green. Almost always get blue. I have 20 blue gems and 8 green. Wow. That's really one-sided, David. Blue grandis, I have to hit on the first turn or I die. If I don't knock him the super resolve and then ping him, I'll die on the next turn. Thank you. That was some Skyfall. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Oh, it's already correct. One, two, three, five, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Yeah, dude, I've only seen two Despharians the entire time I've ever been testing this. Oh, damn it. I miscounted. Did it last time too. Yeah, all Despharian are all Orpharian every time. It's a lot of arcs. No, I don't think you locked a single red or blue. Oh, you locked one blue. Yeah. Oh, you locked a red too. 3, 3, 4.